Hello students, welcome back to the session. In the last session we were talking about the topologies, network topologies, and we also learned about the different types of topologies, that is your bus, star, mesh, hybrid, ring, right? So let us now go to the next part in this, that is the network cables. We had also said we'll talk about the cables in the next session. So let us talk about the network cables. So what is this network cable? So that is, the cables are the ones which are used to connect the different computers which are considered for a network, that is what we call a cable as. There are different types of cables. In that, let us go for the twisted pair cable. Now, what is this twisted pair cables? This twisted pair cables, it was primarily, main purpose was for computer networks. This is also known as your Ethernet cable. Okay, so now almost whatever the, if you are using your LAN, you already know what you mean by LAN, that is local area network. This networks use this cable, and this cable consists of, this is the figure, just a figure I'm showing you. This figure, this cable consists of color coded pairs. This is what you mean by colors, color coded pairs of insulated copper wires. These, inside these wires, the colors, you have got your copper wires. So it is color coded pairs of insulated copper wires. Every, see now, see here, you can see in the figure, you have two wires, right? So these two wires are twisted around each other and it forms one pair, one wire. So two wires are twisted, right? So usually there will be four parts of the wire, four pairs, and each pair will have one solid color and one striped color wire. Okay, see here. And solid colors like the blue, brown, green, orange, and striped wire will be the mixed with the white color. So based on how these pairs are stripped in the plastic sheet, this whatever the upper insulated part, that's the plastic, right? There are two types of twisted pair cables. Okay, that is, one is your UTP, that is unshielded twisted pair. UTP means unshielded twisted pair cable. They are wrapped in a, these are the UTP cables, unshielded twisted pair cables. So they are wrapped in a single plastic sheath. Sheath is nothing but a covering. See here, these wires are covered by one single plastic, and then you have your STP. So this is your STP cable. See, just observe, STP is, full form of STP is shielded twisted pair. Okay, in this cable, each pair whatever you have is wrapped with an additional metal shield. See, just see here, right? It has an extra shield here. So additional metal shield, then all pairs are again wrapped in a single outer plastic sheet. So what are the similarities that you have and the differences that you have between your STP and UTP cables? Now, the first thing, that is, both the STP and similarities we are saying, talking about, both the STP and UTP can transmit data at 10, 100 and 1 Gbps, gigabytes per second, 100 megabytes per second. Okay, so but the, since the difference means, since the STP cable contains more materials, STP is more expensive, because the outer coating, you have two wires are coated in one sheet, and again that is enclosed in one more sheet, right, covering. So it is more expensive than the UTP cable. And similarities, both cables use the same modular connectors. The type of connectors that you use will be the same for both. And STP is more advantageous because it reduces the noise resistance, that is the noise and EMI, electromagnetic induction. You know what I mean by EMI, right? Noise and EMI resistant. Noise and EMI resistant. This is because it has got more coverings, so it is resistant to noise and EMI. And similarities, we say both the cables is around 100 meters, or it can be up to the 100 meters. If you are talking in terms of feet, it is around 328 feet. And both the cables can connect or accommodate a maximum of 1024 nodes in each segment. Okay, this is the figure that you have of your STP and UTP cables. Okay, and if you want to talk about just by understanding the differences, similarities and the differences between those two, we can make out that STP is more advantageous than your UTP because it is noise resistant, EMI resistant, but there is the advantage of STP also, UTP also, that is, it is less expensive, whereas STP is more expensive than your STP. So that is one part or one type of cable. And the second type of cable is your coaxial cable. Coaxial cable. So what is this coaxial cable? This is how your cable looks like. Coaxial cable. It has a conductor. It has a conductor. It has an insulator. And you have a braiding. Right, and you have a sheath, that is the outer covering. Okay, that is the various components, parts that a coaxial cable is made up of, as you can see in the figure. So what is this sheath? Sheath is nothing but the outer layer of the coaxial cable. It protects the cable from physical damage. And you have again the braided shielding. It's again a layer. This shield protects the signals from external interference and noise. That is, this shield is built from the same metal that is used to build the core. This is your core, material is the same, but it is used for noise resistance. And then you have your insulation. Insulation protects the core. It also keeps the core separated from the braid, that's your whatever sheath, braided shielding you have. It separates these two. Because they use the same metal, if this layer, that the insulation is not there, then they may touch each other and there may be a short circuit on the wire, in the wire. So you are using this insulation. And then there you have your conductor. Conductor means it carries the electromagnetic signals. So based on the conductor, whatever type of conductor you are using, there can be two types, that is single core coaxial cable. Single core coaxial cable or a multi core coaxial cable. Okay, so if you want to see the figure, see now, just this is a single pair coaxial cable, this is a multi core coaxial cable. There is a single wire here, there are more than one wires here. Okay, so these cables normally was, first in the beginning it was used for general purpose, that is before the computers came into existence also they were using. Now also it is using for other purposes also, but earlier when there was no, like, just for computers, networks only, there were no wires. So because of that they started using the coaxial cables to build the computer network, and because of its low cost and long durability, coaxial cables were used in computer networking. So this is about the coaxial cables. So it it has a resistance to the disturbances, and it controls signals, and it is expressed in terms of units is ohms. There may various terms here, let us not go into all those things. So coaxial cable was used, so is also one of the type of the cable that is used for your transmission of signals, that is your data. And the next later we have the fiber optic cable, or you can also call it as a optical fiber. So this cable again consists of a core. See, now this is a figure. This consists of a core, and then you have your cladding, and you have a buffer and jacket, the outer covering. You have a jacket. Let us not go into detail about all those things, but just we'll give an explanation. The core is made from a thin strands of plastic, or it might be glass, that can carry data over the long distance, and it is wrapped in the cladding. And again, the cladding is wrapped in the buffer, and buffer is wrapped in the jacket, so that there is no disturbance. So core carries the signals in the form of light. See here, you might have seen this. So this is the, these are the figures for your optical fibers. So it carries the data signals in the form of light, and the cladding reflects the light back to the core, and the buffer protects the light from leaking, and jacket protects the cable from physical damage. So the fiber optic cable is completely immune to EMI, that is your electromagnetic induction, and this cable can transmit data over a longer distance at the highest speed, and it can transmit data up to, this is your, again this is also a figure for your optic cables, and it can transmit data up to 40 kilometers at the speed of 100 gigabits per second. And fiber optic uses, as we said, it uses light to send the data, and it reflects the light from one endpoint to another based on how many beams of light are transmitted at a time. There are two types of fiber optical cable, that is your single mode fiber optical cable and multi-mode fiber optical cable. That is, single mode means it only carries only a single beam of light, and this is more reliable because it supports a higher bandwidth and longer distances there compared to your multi-mode. This cable uses a laser as a light source and transmits, as we said, single mode, we call it as a SMF, one second, SMF, that is your single mode fiber. This carries a single beam of light and higher bandwidth. This is much, it transmits data much longer than your MMF cable, and it transmits up to 1300 or around 1550 nanometer. We are talking in terms of nanometer here, nanometers wavelength of light, that is your single mode fiber. Whereas in your multi-mode, that is your MMF, multi-mode fiber optical cable, it carries multiple beams, more than one beam of light. Because of this, the cable carries much more data than the SMF cable. These are all your multiple, okay, more than, more lights, cables are there, okay. This cable comes, carries more data than the single mode, and it is used for shorter distances. As we said, if you want to use, transmit data over a longer distance, then it is better to use the single mode. If you want over a shorter distance and more faster data transmission, then we can use multi-mode. So this uses an LED as a light source and transmits around 850 or 1300 nanometers wavelength of light. So you might have seen, if you are going for any outing, like during your festivals, fairs, jatre, They sell these lights and all, which the wires, plastic wires, and beam. When you switch it on, the battery, the outside gleams, right? The light comes out of that's nothing but your optical fiber. So this is about the types of cables that we use in your networking. Let us continue the next session with a different matter. Thank you.